You take a look at some of the top free agents. Charlie Morton will be one. Great season with the Astros this year. Patrick Cormann with the Diamondbacks. And then Machado and Harper, and they're always connected with the Yankees. And I just think, and you mentioned Andujar, he's close. He needs work on his defense. Are you willing to trade off $30 million a year or more for Machado for what you're going to pay Andujar and the production you got in his rookie year?
I'm not ready. You know, yeah. This guy offensively is a machine. He had more home runs than I thought he would. And somebody's got to take him this offseason and give him some time away, rest, regroup a little bit, get a little bit stronger, get in the weight room, and then get down to Tampa, Florida, and work on your defensive game. And I think more of the throwing, right? The throwing's got to be a little bit more consistent for Andujar, but he did so much this year and was such a pleasant surprise in the running for the rookie of the year, but there's room for improvement. I think he will.
I'm in agreement with you, and although I know the Yankees will be attached to a lot of these big name free agents, I look at Manny Machado and the potential for a $35 million a year payday. And then you look at Andujar, who will make less than $1 million next year. And it's incumbent upon the Yankees to help make him a better defensive player. The defensive run save statistic worked against him this year. He was a below average third baseman. We saw what happened tonight. He did not play principally because of his defense. They thought CeCe base hit ground balls will be headed towards the left side, but I still think that he's their future third baseman. And as far as Harper goes, another very sexy name, you go back to last year, Stanton kind of cancels out Harper. They've got Hicks, they've got Judge, they've got Stanton. We don't know the future of Gardner and McCutcheon. It'd be hard to squeeze Harper in there unless you're making Stanton a full-time DH. And even though they got under the luxury tax, I'm not sure that means that they want to surge over the luxury tax by X amount of million. Again, we'll see how the offseason unfolds. We know the Yankees will be attached to some of those players.
Yeah, it's almost a conversation with Harper, and he's a great player. There's no doubt about it, but at that price tag, $35 million a year, let's say, does he make you that much better than what you already have? Because you also, by the way, if he's healthy, you have Clint Frazier in the minor leagues as well.
Clint Frazier had a tough year with the concussions. There were so many opportunities that he missed. He's still somebody that they're very high on in the organization. And I'm with Jack. I just don't think the Yankees are ready just to say, we're going to open up the vault and hand all this money out, and that's going to get us over the hump. There's such a good nucleus of young players right here. They're ready to kind of take that next step. I don't know if Harper and Machado fit in from a makeup of this club standpoint.
And Brian Cashman and the members of his front office are so proud of the young players who have come up. And as I said, there are more of those players that are coming. Hal Steinbrenner is on the record as saying multiple times that he doesn't think that a team has to have a $200 million payroll to win a championship. And unless he suddenly changes his tune on that, that's why I think the Yankees are going to continue to be smart and continue to say, as we're saying right here, do you want Andujar for less than $1 million, or do you want Manny Machado for 35? Manny Machado is a wonderful player. He is a marquee franchise type player, but Andujar showed you this year what type of player he could be. And I'm glad you referenced the injuries, because Yankees won 100 games this year. I wrote down some of the guys who had Judge, Sanchez, Gregorius, Hicks, Glaber, Tanaka, CeCe. They weathered a lot of injuries, still won 100 games, still won the wild card game, and still gave the Red Sox a 108-win team, a tough series. The Red Sox proved to be the better team. I think Brian Cashman, Aaron Boone would say the same thing.